this beautiful organ is quite small. As you can see, it only has one manual, but it has a very smart stop list. One of the things that is really smart to do is when you have a small organ like this, that you divide the stops. So, for example, the principal forefoot is divided into bass and treble, but also the trumpet. You also have a small reed, a vox humana, only for the treble. And that way you can make a lot of different combinations that actually sound like a two-manual organ. Well, let's listen to the different stops. In the facade of the organ is the principal forefoot. Extra, we have a principal 8-foot in the treble, so you can use that as a solo stop, but of course you can play it in chords as well, as long as you stay in the second half of the manual. Gedackt 8-foot is the kind of foundation of the organ, a beautiful flute. And of course, since it's a 4-foot organ, you can have an 8-foot stopped stop in the organ. So that means it has the length of the principal 4-foot, but it sounds like an 8-foot stop. So the Gedackt 8-foot. From that 8-foot on, I can build the bigger sounds of the organ. So on the 8-foot, I have the 4-foot principal, and later I can add the Qvinta 3-foot and the octave 2-foot to have a nice, strong and brilliant sound. tell that the 3-foot and the 2-foot are really strong, and the organ doesn't have a mixture, but you don't really miss out on it because it has a very bright and powerful sound. Well, we already heard the 8-foot flute, and then we have as a special treat 2 4-foot flutes. One is a Rörflöjt, so that means it's a flute which is stopped but has a little chimney on top, and it sounds like this. And the other 4-foot flute is a Spetsflöjt 4-foot, and that means it is a tapered flute. So it's open, it's more or less shaped like a normal principal, but it's tapered, so it's more narrow at the top, and it gives a very special sound, and it's one of the most beautiful stops in this organ. Something else that is quite special in this organ, we have 2 reeds. You would expect on a small one-manual organ that it only has 1 reed, and then probably a dulcian or a trumpet. And especially a trumpet is of course nice for the congregational singing, that you have a loud reed stop. But here we have 2, not only the trumpet, which is indeed quite loud, but we also have a very delicate vox humana. And it's only in the treble, and that means you can use it as a solo stop against one of the other stops that are divided. But let's listen to the trumpet first. Vox humana, which actually means human voice, by itself it sounds like this. One of the options is that you accompany it with the 4-foot flute, so I can play with my left hand the 4-foot an octave down, and then I have the vox humana together with the 4-foot flute in the right hand, in the treble, and it gives a nice solo stop. Thank you. also add the Gedackt 8-foot to the same sound. I can even use the principal 4-foot in the bass and then add the principal 8-foot in the treble together with the vox humana, which gives it a little edge, and that way you have another solo stop. These divisions are, you can use it in very different ways. So I already have this principal 8-foot treble now, and that's also a stop you can accompany, for example, with the 4-foot flute in the bass. For the crazy people, you can even do very funny things, like having the Qvinta 3-foot with the principal 8-foot in the treble, so you have a beautiful 8 and 3-foot sound, but then you have to accompany in the bass in a different key so that it matches again. So if I play in C major in the treble, I have to accompany in F major in the bass with a 3-foot. Gives you lots of options that way. And also we have the trumpet divided in bass and treble. So in the treble you can use it, for example, with only the, let's say, the 8-foot Gedackt, and in the bass I will have the principal 4-foot together with the 8-foot, of course, and then we have a nice solo stop for playing English voluntaries, for example. I can have 8 and 4-foot in the treble and then the trumpet in the bass. Although it's a small organ, it has an endless variety of stop combinations. So let's improvise a large partita, lots of variations on a hymn tune, to see how many different sounds I can come up with. Thank you.
Thank you.
Squeak! Okay, so then I start with a little story about the bellows, and then I will do the whole organ demo with the engine on. Okay, fine. This wonderful little organ has a special treat. You can actually thread the bellows in old style. So of course we do have an engine now, but you can also do it by threading the bellows, and it gives a slightly different sound. And of course that has to do with the fact that when the engine is on, you have a constant pressure, and it changes, of course, when you do it in the old style. So it definitely affects the sound a little bit. So let's listen to the difference. I will just play a short piece, and let's see what happens.